Fusion research has significantly grown, but there exists a large gap from the present state to a demo reactor. Studies of linear plasma devices are critically important.
The lifetime of the first wall determines the economy of a nuclear fusion reactor. For the future demonstration reactor demo, it's necessary to qualify material concepts already today. Dedicated test facilities are needed. The Plasma Research Center here in Tsukuba is such a test facility.
University of Tsukuba is one of the top research universities in Japan, with over 16,000 students and 1,800 professors. Fundamental science is an essential part of research in the university. We have 3 Nobel laureates, and our Faculty of Health and Sports Sciences has produced more than 40 Olympic and Paralympic medals. The university has more than 20 research centers for innovations, covering broad scientific fields. The Plasma Research Center has a long history of exploring plasma physics and nuclear fusion using the world's largest tandem mirror machine.
The University of Tsukuba's Plasma Research Center was established in 1979 and has achieved notable plasma performance using the world's largest tandem mirror machine Gamma 10, working towards a nuclear fusion device. We have achieved high ion temperatures comparable to fusion plasma.
Plasma Research Center is an important player in a large collaboration of the International Energy Agency with partners from Australia, Europe, Japan, and the United States. The research here in Tsukuba has already brought important insight to the performance of plasma facing materials.
The center's research strategy has evolved to study plasma transport and boundary plasma controls, making the best use of the tandem mirror machine.
In nuclear fusion plasmas, fluctuation causes plasma conformance degradation. Therefore, suppression of fluctuation is a key issue for moving forward in magnetically confined plasma studies. We researched the flute and drift types of fluctuation suppressions caused by the E+V rotation and or E+V drift shear produced by the application of electron cyclotron resonance heating. We have also developed the advanced plasma diagnostics required for electron temperature and density research to study the important plasma parameters of plasma conditions. We developed the dual-pass Thomson scattering system to simultaneously measure core and edge plasmas.
Control of detached plasmas using plasma gas interaction is important for handling heat and particle loss onto the diverter plate of magnetic fusion devices. Our Gamma 10 PDX Endros plasma has an equivalent ion temperature to boundary plasma for magnetic fusion devices. We have performed characterization of plasma detachment using the diverter simulation experimental module. We have made experimental and analytical progress towards the understanding of the atomic and molecular processes of boundary plasmas.
We have also developed high-power gyrotrons that are used for electron heating and production of electrostatic potentials for plasma confinement.
We have developed megawatt-power level gyrotron with a wide frequency range of 40 to 300 gigahertz. The gyrotrons we developed have been applied not only to plasma experiment of the Gamma 10 PDX, but also for the large helical device at the National Institute for Fusion Science and Quest at Kyushu University. Recently, in addition to nuclear fusion energy development, we have collaboratively applied gyrotron to microwave rocket and wireless powered transmission capabilities.
The Plasma Research Center is a core research center in a bilateral collaboration with Japan's National Institute for Fusion Science, promoting domestic and international collaborations in fusion research. A new superconducting mirror machine is being constructed to take our diverter study even further. This will make a major contribution to the development of DEMO, International Demonstration Power Station, and bring us closer to realizing the world's first nuclear fusion power station.
I'm very confident that the Plasma Research Center will continue to give important contributions to the qualification of first-wall materials, which are absolutely necessary for the success of fusion.